Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Let's carry on with this. And what we want to do is we want to get into this section here, the Google AdSense at the top here. Okay. Don't worry, we're going to come back and tidy everything up towards the end. I just want to get the actual structure laid out, and we can, because we still got to put content in. So we want to get this in. So what I want to do is I want to go to my code view, and outside of the header, so this is the header. Outside of that, I want to make another div id, and I'm going to call it let's call it Green AdSense, just so I know what it is. Like I say, you can call it anything you want. Let's come to the style sheet, and let's call upon that id, starts with a hash sign, green underscore AdSense, open and close. So what do I want to do? The first thing I want to do is margin 0 space auto, because I'm going to make this center aligned in the middle of the page. To do that, I'm going to have to specify a width of it, which the width was 731 pixels. Is that correct? Where is it? Top AdSense, 731 by 40 pixels. Height 40. No, the height's not 40 pixels. It can't be that big. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? 24 pixels. I was going to say it's massive. Okay, height 24 pixels. And let's bring in the background image, which is, he says, top AdSense. Okay. And I'm going to want a no repeat. Okay. And I'm going to also want a bottom left. I don't want any repeating, but I want to make sure it's down to the bottom to the left hand side. Okay, I'm going to push it down, and there we go. That should be okay. If we come into design view, you'll notice it's in here. I'm just thinking we might need to clear both here. One sec. It's in there. It's looking okay. I'm going to add a clear both, because we floated the header left and the header right above it. It's just sometimes a good habit to get into. I'm going to put it in anyway. Clear both. Just in case. Let's have a look, see if it's okay. And there we go. We got it in there, and we're going to stick our AdSense in there in a bit. Next thing we got is, moving on down, we've got the main content section now. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a wrap for the whole content. Okay. Then I'm going to split it up to being, first I'm going to make this section here, up to here, content left, this section, content right. Okay. And then inside of the content left, we're going to have another two divs, one being for here, and one being for here. This is normally how I split up three columns. Okay, so let's get on with it, and I'll show you what I mean. So first, let's make a whole wrap. Make sure you're outside of all wraps, all divs, sorry. And let's do a div id content underscore wrap. This means we're going to, it's going to be the whole of the content's going to go inside of this content wrap. Okay, let's make some space, make sure you're inside of it. Next, div id, and I'm going to want a left content. Okay, let's close that off, and I'm going to want a div id right content. You can call them anything you want, like, you know, but this is my brain, this is how it works. Come on, Ali. There we go. Div ID left content, div ID right content. And inside of the left content, I'm going to have a div ID, and I'm going to call this left nav. Okay. Left navigation. Let me just make some space so you can see these divs properly. Oops. Okay, so we got the left content, and we got the left nav going inside of the left content. But then I also want, which at the moment is this section, this is going to be called the left. You've got the whole content. Okay, you've got the whole content. Then you got this section, which is the left content. And then you've also got this section that's going to be the right content. Okay. And now we've just made a left navigation, which is this bit. Now I want to make a right sort of like content section. So let's come back in here, and inside of the left content we want to make another div id, and I'm going to call this right, I don't know, right text. Whatever. Okay, left content, left nav. Okay, it's looking good. Let's get stylizing. So the first thing we want to stylize is the whole content wrap. Okay, and I'm just gonna put in, this is end of header. These are just comments, so I like to comment my code just so I know that that's where the header area ends. And let's start here with the ID, which is the hash sign, and it's called content wrap. Okay, let's get formatting that. So we basically know the width of it already is 1000 pixels. Okay, what I generally do at the beginning is I specify a height and then take it out later. So I'm going to specify a height of 600 pixels. Once I have something in it, I'll take it out. This is going to be a height of auto, so it doesn't matter. So the content wrap, header, content wrap, and I need to center align it. So margin 0 space auto. Okay, that's that center line. Next we had the left content and the right content. Okay, so again, left underscore content, and what do I want to do for the left content? Come back in a Photoshop and get just a rough size of what it's going to be. I want it to about there. Come to my info, that's about 807 pixels. We're going to be adjusting this, but first I want to float this to be to the left, okay, because this is the left content. Then I want to be a width of, I'm going to call it 800 pixels, and the height at the moment, again, I'm going to specify something, but we're going to change it. Okay, that's the left. Then I want the right content, and I want it to be a float right, because we floated the other one left. What am I doing? Float right. I want to have a width. Again, we can work out the width. We know the width of the left content is 800, so the width of this one's going to be 200 pixels. It more than likely we're going to have to change some stuff here. And again, I'm going to specify height, but we're going to change it to auto later on. Okay, so we got the left content, we got the content wrap, and we got the right content. And let's have a look how we're getting on. Here is the right content. Here is the left content, and then we still got this div here, which is going to be the left navigation. And then we'll have another div in there that's going to be the right text. So let's format the left navigation. You know, sometimes it's good just to get yourself organized, okay? Get these divs in shape and we can tidy things up towards the end. So, left navigation. What have we got happening with this left navigation? I'm going to want the left navigation, which is this section here. I'm going to want it to be roughly a width of 300 pixels. Okay, this left navigation has to float left because it's inside of a div called left content, but we need it to float left because in a minute we're going to have the left navigation, we're going to have the right content text, which is going to float right. So float that left. Let's make it a width of 300, of 300 pixels. My fingers are everywhere today. Finger pixels. Height again is going to be changed. I'm just going to make it 300 pixels, and that's looking good. I'm just making the structure, and then we'll come back in and stylize it all. And then the last one I got is the right text, CSS. I'm going to copy this, save time, and right underscore text. Like I said, I'm going a little bit faster here. Okay, so this is where the maths comes in. We know that the left content is 800 pixels. Okay, we know that inside of that left content is the left nav and the right text. So if it's 800 pixels width, if we took away 300 pixels, 876, 500 pixels. So this width is going to be 500 pixels. And there we go. So we got everything pretty much lined up now. Let's have a look. And here it is. We've got our main content, which is this section here. We then floated a left content. That's the right content. This is the... Nope. This is the... Come on, baby. This is the left content here. Then what we did inside of the left content, we made a left nav, and then we made a div right nav. We made this section here. Okay, and that's us all formatted. In the next tutorial, we'll come back, we'll start adding some information and getting this baby rocking and rolling. Take it easy, guys and girls.